Hello, class 5, how you all? So, we have been studying chapter number 4. Today, we will complete this chapter. So, types of solution, we are talking about, last time we studied miscible liquid, immiscible liquid, type of solution. So, we will again revise, then we will study, okay? Then we will study the next point, okay? So, what do you mean by solution? Yes, solution is a uniform mixture which contains two or more substances. What is solution? Solution is a uniform mixture which contains two or more substances. There are three types of solution: saturated solution, unsaturated solution, supersaturated solution. Saturated solution, unsaturated solution, super saturated solution. Saturated solution means no more solute can be dissolved. Yes, solute and solvent, you know, solute is that thing which dissolve in solvent, and solvent means dissolving medium. So saturated solution is a solution in which no more solute can dissolve, and unsaturated solution is a solution in which more solute can be dissolved, okay? And supersaturated solution, what is the meaning of supersaturated solution? Becomes unstable, yes, solution which becomes unstable. Solution which becomes unstable and form crystals. Solution which becomes unstable and form crystal is known as supersaturated solution, okay? I hope that you understood all three: saturated solution, unsaturated solution, and supersaturated solution. Now, let's move on to the next point. Okay, let's talk about two different type of liquids: miscible liquid and immiscible liquid, okay? Kids, suppose that I have a glass of water and I pour some salt. Tell me, will the salt dissolve or not? The salt will dissolve. Now, if I try to dissolve soil, S-O-I-L, if I try to dissolve soil, Can I dissolve the soil? No, I can't dissolve, because soil cannot be dissolved. So such kind of solution is immiscible. So what is the meaning of immiscible and miscible? Miscible means liquids that can dissolve in one another is called miscible. Miscible is that liquid, those liquid which can easily dissolve. Yes, for example, sugar can dissolve in water, sugar can dissolve in milk, so it is miscible. And immiscible means liquids that do not dissolve in another, which is called immiscible, okay? Immiscible means liquids that do not dissolve in another. Yes, for example, if I have water and if I try to dissolve oil, can I dissolve oil in water? No, I cannot dissolve. So it is the examples of immiscible. I hope you understood the difference between miscible and immiscible. Okay, now let's move on to the next point. Okay, as you can see, the definition, again I have written in different language, miscible and immiscible. You can write this definition, these two definition, or the previous definition in previous slide that I showed you. You can write that definition or you can write this definition, okay? Any definition you can write, okay? No problem. So you can see the meaning of miscible and immiscible. Check the spelling of miscible, kids. try to memorize the spelling M I S C I B L E. M I S C I B L E, miscible. And immiscible, I M M I S C I B L E, miscible. Okay. So what is the meaning of miscible? Two liquids that completely dissolve in each other are miscible liquids. Okay. And two liquids that are not miscible. Not miscible means not dissolved. Okay. In each other are immiscible liquid. Okay. Two liquids that completely dissolve in each other are miscible liquids, and two liquids that completely that do not dissolve. Two liquids that do not dissolve in each other are immiscible liquid. Okay. Example, you already know. Suppose I have, you can imagine water, or you can imagine I have milk, I add Bonvita, then what will happen? Bonvita will dissolve. Yes, am I right? So it is messy. Okay. And if I try to dissolve petrol in milk, ghee in milk, they do not dissolve. You can easily see the separate layer. Okay. So again, the separate layer actually shows which is miscible and which is immiscible. Okay. If you can't see separate layer, if you can't see two different layer, it means it is miscible. Okay. I hope you understood. Now, on the next point. So kids, as you can see, the carbonated water, soda water plus orange juice, yes. So when I add carbonated water in orange juice, then what will happen? Will you see carbonated water through your eyes? Can you see carbonated water through your eyes? No, you cannot see. Then tell me kids, what kind of solution is it? I showed you this one in a previous class. I'm giving you 10 seconds to think. Your time starts now. So kids, you can easily guess that solution which can dissolve in each other, liquids which can dissolve in each other are miscible. And if liquids cannot dissolve, they are immiscible. So you can see, you cannot see your separate layer. It means it is miscible. Okay. It means it is miscible. I hope you understood. Now let's go on the next point. Okay. Now, as you can see the different color, the glass is looking so beautiful. Yes, so beautiful glass. Yes, you can see yellow color, white color, orange color. I think yellow is it is oil, and white is I think maybe milk, but I don't know what is orange. Maybe orange juice. Yes. So as you can see, three color are also in our flag. Okay. Look the picture kids carefully. Look it and tell me, is it immiscible or miscible? Is it immiscible or miscible? Try to recall the definition of miscible and immiscible. Try to recall the definition of miscible and immiscible, okay? I'm giving you 5 seconds. So kids, it is immiscible. It is immiscible. Why? Because two liquids that are not dissolved in each other are immiscible liquids. So it is immiscible. Okay? Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, now let's talk about expansion and contraction. Yes, expansion and contraction. So, expansion means increasing the size, expanding. Okay, expansion means expanding. And contraction means shrinking, decreasing the size. When does it happen? It happens when we either increase temperature or decrease temperature. Yes, when we give heat, when heat is given, or when it is cooled down. Okay, so expansion is the process of expanding the size, enlarging the size. Okay, contraction is the process of shrinking the size, decreasing the size. Okay, when substance expand or contact, the particle is still the same size. Yes, suppose you are hitting iron. So when you heat iron, that time what will happen? The size will expand, the size will increase. And when you heat, during heating, the particle of iron will start moving faster, move very fast and fast and fast. And but the size of particle will remain same. They will move, but the size of particle will not change, okay? So when substance expand or contract, the particle stay the same. Okay? Next, only the spaces between the particles changes. Only the spaces between the particle changes. Okay? Means they just move away from each other. That's why the space increase between them. Okay? The particles in the solid vibrate more when it is heated. Thus take up room, more room. Okay? The particle in the solid vibrate more. Yes, when you heat something, that time particle start vibrating faster. Okay, and they take more space because they start to expand. Okay, they need more space because they increase, start spreading. Okay, they start spreading. Similar to liquid and gases when heated. Yes, it happens same when we heat the gas or liquid, because when we heat liquid and gas, the particle move faster in all direction. Okay, now let's move on to the next point. Look this picture. As you can see, the balloon, yes, increasing by size of balloon. You can see when gas particles get hot, they take up more space and they expand. Yes, kids, you know, if you have any balloon, yes, if you have any balloon and the gas which is filled inside the balloon, if it get hot, if it's get hot, then what will happen? The size will increase, it will expand, it will expand. So you can say, when gas particle gets hot, they take up space and they expand. Yes, the size will start increasing, the size will start increasing automatically, the size will increase. Yes, it's true. Even, you know, kids, if you try to fill more gas in a balloon, if you suppose you have cool air, if you try to fill through your mouth, then when you will fill air, then size increase. Why? Because during filling time, the particle are vibrating faster, so they are moving away from each other, and more gases has more particle. More gas has more particle. That's why it expands. I hope you understood that expansion process, that when substance expand, the particle stay the same size. The particle in the solid vibrate more when it is heated, thus take up more space in room. I hope you understood. Now let's see the contraction example. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, kids, as you can see, the example of contraction in solid, contraction in liquid, contraction in gases, yes. So as you can see, the first example, contraction in solid, if we hold a very hot glass tumbler under cold water, then what will happen? It cracks, yes. Suppose you have very hot glass tumbler, and if you take away under cold water, then what will happen? It will crack. This is because the outer surface of the glass come in direct contact with cold water and contract. Yes, because the outer surface comes in direct contact with cold water, and due to decreasing temperature, due to coldness, always substance shrink. Okay, so in the try of shrink, it cracks. So in direct contact with cold water and contracts more as compared to the inner surface. That's why the outer surface shrink, which is the example of contraction. If we see the example of contraction in liquid, as you can see, we observe that water expand on heating. Can you say what will happen if the water is allowed to cool down and then poured back into the glass? Yes. And what will happen? Would it still overflow? No, this is because of contraction. Okay, so you can easily observe that water expand on heating. Yes. Can you say that what will happen if the water is allowed to cool down and then poured back into glass? It will not still overflow because of contraction. Yes. If an inflate, now let's see the example of contraction in gases. Contraction in gases. If an inflated balloon is tied at the mouth of the bottom and the bottle is placed in a ice cold water, then what will happen? The balloon will shrink inside as the air inside the balloon contracts on cooling. Yes, it will contract on cooling. Okay, so you can see contraction in solid, contraction in liquid, and contraction in gases. You can see the examples. Okay, first, please write down. I'm giving you 10 seconds. So, kids, you can see first is contraction in solid. If we hold a very hot glass tumbler under cold water, it cracks. This is because the outer surface of the glass comes in direct contact with water and contact more as compared to the inner surface. Second is contraction in liquid. We observe that water expand on heating. Can you see what will happen if the water is allowed to cool down and then poured back into a glass? Would it still overflow? No, this is because of contraction. Next is contraction in gases. If an inflated balloon is tied at the mouth of the bottle and the bottle is placed in ice cold water, what will happen? The balloon will shrink in size as the air inside the balloon contracts on cooling. I hope you understood. Okay, it's now I want to ask you, how many state of matter, solid, liquid, gas? Yes? No, you are wrong. Let's move on to the next point. So kids, as you can see, there are 5 state of matter, solid, liquid, gas, plasma, and Bose-Einstein condensate. Yes. But you are in lower class or in lower class, we talk about only solid liquid gas. What is plasma and Bose-Einstein condensate? Plasma and Bose-Einstein condensate, both are actually gases. Both are actually gases. Plasma is even found in the sun. Yes, in a star it is found, okay? Now, if you want to write, you can write down. I am giving you 10 seconds. Please write down. Okay, it's now let's move on to the next point. So kids, you can see the change in state of matter. Yes, sublimation, vaporization, condensation, melting, freezing. What is sublimation? The process of converting solid into gas and gas into solid without changing into liquid is known as sublimation. What is melting? The process of changing solid into liquid is known as melting. What is freezing, or you can say what is solidification? The process of changing liquid into solid is known as freezing, or you can say solidification. Okay. What is vaporization? The process of changing liquid into gas is known as vaporization. What is condensation? The process of changing gas into liquid is known as condensation. Okay. And what is deposition? Deposition means the process of changing gas into solid is known as deposition. Okay. So remember, kids, melting means changing solid into liquid. It happens when the temperature increases. What is freezing, or you can say what is solidification? The process of changing, the process of converting liquid into solid. It happens when the temperature is decreasing, when you cool down. What is vaporization? The process of converting liquid into gas. It is all vaporization is also known as evaporation. Okay. It happens when you heat something. Okay. Condensation. The process of converting gas into liquid is called condensation. Condensation happens when you cool down something. Okay. Sublimation. The process of changing solid into gas or gas into solid is known as sublimation. It generally happens when you heat or cool. Okay. I hope you understood. Now, let's move on to the next point. Okay, it's, as you can see, I have written all solid, liquid, gas difference. They means their characteristic in box. I thought that I should show you all the characteristic in the box so you can easily understand. Okay. So you can see, kids, that first characteristic is shape. You can see solid, liquid, gas in the box. So solid has definite shape, liquids do not have definite shape, and gas do not have definite shape. Volume, if we talk about the second characteristic, volume, solid has definite shape, liquid has definite volume. Solid has definite volume. Yes, solid has definite volume, liquid has definite volume, but gas do not have definite volume. Next characteristic, rigidity. Solid rigidity means strong, how much strong, or it can flow or not. Okay. Solid is rigid and cannot flow. Okay. And liquid, not rigid, it can flow. Gas, not rigid, and it can flow. Compressibility, can you compress it or not? Okay. When you apply pressure, can you easily compress or not? So solid is incompressible, liquid is less compressible, gas is highly compressible. Yes, solid is incompressible, liquid is less compressible, gas is highly compressible. Next characteristic, intermolecular space. So you can see solid have least intermolecular space. What is the meaning of intermolecular space? Intermolecular space means the space between the particles, means the space between the molecule, or you can say particle, okay, means the space between the atom, okay, or you can say, okay, intermolecular space means the space between the molecules, means particle, okay. So you can see the solid have least intermolecular space, liquid has more than solid but less than liquid, less than gases, okay, and gives maximum intermolecular space. Okay, I hope you understood. Now let's move on to the next one. Okay kids, now look this picture. These are the examples of physical changes and chemical changes. You know that physical changes are reversible, chemical changes are not reversible. In physical changes, no new product form, but in chemical changes, always new product form. Okay, physical changes means change in physical properties, and chemical changes mean change in chemical properties. Okay, so you can see some example: melting of ice, chopping of wood, mixing gray and green marbles, burning of wood, rotting banana, mixing vinegar and baking soda, and fireworks. Okay, these are the example. You will think and tell me. I will not tell you that which is the example of physical change and which is the example of chemical change. Think yourself and tell me. First is melting of ice. Think and give the answer. Chopping of wood. Think and tell me. It is physical change or chemical change. Mixing gray and green marble. Think it is physical change or chemical change. Burning of wood. It is physical change or chemical change. Rotting banana. Think it is physical change or chemical change. Fireworks. Is it physical change or chemical change? Mixing vinegar and baking soda. Is it physical change or chemical change? Vinegar means acetic acid, okay? Means silica, okay? Silica we call acetic acid, okay? Now, let me give you the answer, okay? Melting of ice, chopping of wood, and mixing gray and green marble, these are the examples of physical changes. And which are the example of chemical changes? Burning of wood, rotting banana, fireworks, mixing vinegar and baking soda, these are the examples of chemical changes. I hope you understood. Now, let's move on to the last point. Okay, it's question number one. Differentiate between solid, liquid and gases. And previous class, I think I showed you this question, but I am showing you again, okay? So, first of all, let's talk about shape. Solid has definite shape. Liquid has no definite shape. Gas has no definite shape, okay? Volume. Solid has definite volume, liquid has definite volume, but gas has no definite volume. Rigidity, solids are rigid, liquids are not rigid, and gases are not rigid. Compressibility, solids are incompressible, liquids are less compressible, and all the gases are highly compressible. Intermolecular space, solids has least intermolecular space, liquids has more than solid but less than gases, and gases has maximum intermolecular space. Next question, explain expansion and contraction with example. Yes, what is expansion and contraction? Expansion is the way of expanding the size of something. Means expansion is the process of increasing the size when it is heated. Okay, so you can say the process of increasing the size, expanding the size when an object is heated. Contraction, the process of decreasing the size, the process of shrinking the size when object is cooling down. Okay, you can see the example example of expansion. When gas particle gets hot, they take up more space and they expand. And the example of contraction is if we hold a very hot glass tumbler under cold water, it cracks. This is because the outer surface of the glass comes in direct contact with cold water and contracts more as compared to the inner surface. Okay, I hope you understood. Now our chapter is complete. Now we'll meet in next chapter, next class. Till then, bye bye.